This video is going to explain the importance of keeping blood phosphate at a safe level. It will explain what a low phosphate diet is and show you types and portion sizes of phosphate containing foods. This video will also explain types of phosphate binders and how they work. Phosphate is a mineral in our body. It helps generate energy from carbohydrates. The majority, 70 to 85% of phosphorus, in the body is combined with calcium and stored in the bones and teeth. Only 1% of the phosphorus in our body is circulating in our blood. Phosphorus can also be found in body cell membranes and is involved in muscle and nerve function. You can find phosphate in most protein foods, such as dairy products, meat, fish, and seafood. It is also widely used as a food additive, preservative, and stabilizer in processed foods and drink to keep them moist and fresh for longer. When the kidney is functioning normally, any extra phosphate we consume from food and drinks will be filtered by the kidney and excreted from our bodies via urine. Therefore, our blood phosphate will be maintained at a stable level. When kidney function is reduced, the extra phosphate will build up in the blood. The medical term for this is hyperphosphatemia. High blood phosphate can remove calcium from the bone, which leads to the bone weakening. Raised phosphate level can cause hardening of the blood vessels and soft tissues by depositing both calcium and phosphate. This can lead to cardiovascular disease. These issues combined are known as chronic kidney disease, mineral and bone disorders, CKD, MBD, and can have a significant negative impact on long-term health. Most people have no symptoms when their phosphate level is increased. Other people may have the following symptoms, such as itching, joint pain, muscle pain, weakness, rash or bumps on the skin, red and itchy eyes, constipation, and nausea. Not everyone with reduced kidney function has issues with blood phosphate level. According to the British Renal Association Clinical Practice Guideline in Mineral and Bone Disorders and CKD 2011, target blood phosphate level depends on the stage of kidney failure and types of renal replacement therapy. When you have high blood phosphate level, you may be asked to see a renal dietitian and recommended to follow a low phosphate diet. If you are a pre-dialysis patient, you are recommended to limit your daily phosphate intake to 600 to 1000 mg per day. For hemodialysis and peritoneal dialysis patients, your recommended daily phosphate limit is 1000 to 1400 mg per day. Please do not restrict your diet until advised to do so by a doctor or dietitian. This table shows the phosphate content of some common food we consume. If you need to follow a low phosphate diet, please do not worry about these numbers. Your dietitian will give you advice on your allowances for these foods and will ensure you're following a healthy, balanced diet. Phosphate absorption from food depends on the types of food. Phosphate is absorbed more readily from animal foods than plant-based foods. Inorganic phosphate, such as phosphate additives in processed food, can be absorbed up to 90 to 100% by our body, but their content is not clearly labelled on food items. Therefore, where possible, you're encouraged to cook fresh foods from scratch. Check the ingredient list if possible, and look out for the ingredients of anything spelling with P-H-O-S, phos. This table shows the E numbers and the chemical names of some common phosphates. Your renal dietitian will take a diet history from you to find out the portion size of certain foods you eat and how often you have them. Based on current intake, appetite, food choices and preference, blood test results and medications, your dietitian will recommend making changes to your diet in terms of frequency and portion size of the high phosphate food. In the first instance, you will be encouraged to avoid some less nutritious high phosphate foods, such as Coke, Pepsi and certain types of frozen meals. Based on your height and weight, stage of CKD or renal replacement therapy and general health, your dietitian will calculate your daily protein requirements. They can advise you to maintain an adequate, good quality protein intake without excessive dietary phosphate consumption. Let's look at two diets and compare their phosphate level. Fried pork sausage with an egg, baked beans on a slice of wholemeal bread with a cup of milk for breakfast. For the snack, a can of cola with a large flapjack. For lunch, a plateful of macaroni cheese with Greek yogurt and honey. Later in the afternoon, a snack of nuts and raisins. Dinner, 5-ounce rump steak with 2 potato waffles and some side vegetables. Bedtime snack, a slice of wholemeal bread with peanut butter. The total phosphate content of this diet is 2,491 milligrams. That is more than double the daily phosphate recommendation. Now, let's look at another diet. A cup of tea with jam and toast for breakfast, a plum with a glass of diluted squash as a mid-morning snack, a tuna sandwich with a trifle and a pear for lunch, mince and potatoes with salad for dinner, a cup of tea with a digestive biscuit as a bedtime snack. The total phosphate content of this diet is 739 milligrams. Milk contains phosphate too, but it is a good source of high quality protein and calcium. You can still have half a pint of milk per day. Please avoid dried milk powder, evaporated milk, condensed milk, and coffee mate. Over-the-counter milkshake supplements are usually high in phosphate. If you need nutritional supplements, please contact your GP, renal consultants, or specialist nurses to refer you to see a renal dietitian. You may also come across different plant-based alternatives to cow's milk. If you prefer plant-based milks, you can use them as long as you are keeping to your daily fluid allowance. Fortified organic plant-based milk contains more phosphate. This table shows the phosphate content of different types of milk per 100 milliliters. Phosphate content of different brands of the plant-based milk can vary from 5.2 milligrams to 97 milligrams per 100 milliliters. The phosphate content of different types of cheese varies. Processed cheese spread contains the highest amount of phosphate proportion. Lowest phosphate cheese options are cottage cheese, ricotta, mascarpone, and cream cheese. Keep soft cheese such as brie, feta, and mozzarella to 60 grams per portion. For hard cheeses such as cheddar, Edam, Gouda, and Wensleydale, limit to 30 grams per portion. Your dietitian can advise you on how often and how much cheese you can have. Here are some low phosphate snack ideas. Different types of alcohol contain different amounts of phosphate. You may consider changing the types of alcohol drinks to reduce the phosphate intake. For alcohol, the general rule is the darker the beer, the higher the phosphate content. Wine and spirits contain less phosphate per measure. Phosphate binders are medications used to bind to the phosphate from our food in the gut and then carry the excess phosphate out of the body in the feces. This reduces the phosphate absorption of the food from the gut into the blood. Before starting phosphate binders, your doctor may refer you to a renal dietitian to assess your dietary phosphate intake. The dietitian may give you some advice to reduce your daily phosphate intake. If you are already on phosphate binders, your dietitian can tell you how to distribute your tablets in the best way to match your daily meal pattern. You must make sure to take your phosphate binders with your food. There are two main types of binder: calcium-containing and non-calcium-containing binders. Binders are tablets that can be chewable or swallowed whole. Some binders are in powder form for mixing up with water or food. Regarding binder distribution, usually you are recommended to take more binders with a meal which contains more phosphate. It can be flexible with your meal pattern, however, you should still aim to take the total number prescribed for each day. If you're having a high phosphate snack, such as cheese on crackers, you may take the spare binder at the snack time. Remember, the time and dosage you take your phosphate binder can change according to your meal pattern and phosphate content of your meals. You may change it according to the difference of your weekday and weekend routine difference. You can discuss with your renal dietitian about the best way to distribute your phosphate binders to make them most efficient for you. You may find following the low phosphate diet very complicated at the beginning, but you will soon realise that by just doing some simple changes, you can significantly reduce your total phosphate intake. You can also try a plant-based diet by reducing some high phosphate containing animal protein to plant-based alternatives like lentils and pulses. You can also mix half beef mince with half corn so as to reduce the absorption of dietary phosphate from the animal source. Dietary phosphate allowance depends on the blood phosphate level. As mentioned before, many factors affect blood phosphate level. Your renal dietitian will advise you when and how to adjust your intake so as to keep your blood phosphate within the normal level. If you follow a traditional diet, then your dietitian can help you adapt your diet accordingly.